Go.
In Australia, the reported number of same-sex couples have more than tripled from 1996 to 2011.
From a time that marrying the same sex could lead to imprisonment, to a time where gay marriage is openly accepted in more than 24 countries across the world, our global community has grown in diversity immensely.
Our society has come a long way, without a doubt. However, we can't forget that homosexuality used to be criminalized and considered a taboo subject. In the late 19th century, the then-renowned German Empire was the first to criminalize homosexuality. All in all, 140,000 men were convicted of being gay.
Later on, the United States, now considered one of the freest countries in the world, went on to publicly bash gays. In 1913, a newspaper in Portland, Oregon wrote, "All the faggots will be dressed in drag at the ball tonight," using the word faggot in reference to gays.
From then on, publicly bashing gays using words such as faggot and dyke became normal. Being gay, which used to be something happy, suddenly became an insult and something that nobody wanted to be.
Today, one of the most researched things on Google is fag jokes. However, according to Stephen David Owitz, retirement communities are 30 times more likely to research fag jokes than teens and young adults. Which brings us to our next point. What changed? How and why?
The years of 1999 and 2000 not only marked the beginning of a new century, but also the beginning of a new generation, Generation Z. Along with this new generation come new values. Not only do we accept diversity like the millennials, but we celebrate it.
This is the main reason for which we are becoming globally accepting towards the LGBT+ community. 65% of 18 to 29-year-olds say that homosexual relationships should be legal, compared to only 33% of those aged 65 and older. Younger generations are becoming more liberal and accepting.
We are not only making progress in Western countries. Young Muslim people today have values that are comparable to those of young people in Western Europe in the 1960s.
These are astonishing statistics, showing that we are getting better. Slowly, but we are getting better.
Although we are making progress, it is not an easy fight. There are still homophobic people in the world today that choose to use hate and violence over love to express themselves.
Recent incidents of gay bashing, like the shooting of the Orlando nightclub, have continuously occurred, causing us to think that humanity has reached its peak point and is once again decreasing. So why are we telling you all this?
Because our hopes are that people like us, 10 to 15 years from now, won't have to stand here explaining why LGBTQ people should have the same rights, because by then, we believe that will already be the case. Join the fight.
Thank you.